This is a footage of the clouds over Lincoln, Nebraska. It's there to remind us that air is liquid too. Or at least it behaves like liquid. Buoyancy, a concept firstly described over 2000 years ago, when a man called Archimedes was taking a bath. What buoyancy tells us is that every liquid will exert a force upon an object that is submerged into it. How much force, you ask? The exact same amount as it's needed to displace the liquid around that object. That's why things float in water. If you have a boat that's overall less dense than water, then it would float. Thanks, buoyancy. But air is fluid, so this very same concept should apply here too. And it does. If you were to make a ship that is less dense than air, it would float. That's how zeppelins and hot air balloons work. But hot air balloons are a bit boring compared to a mile-wide floating city. A 119 years ago, a genius was born, Buckminster Fuller. His idea went something like this. Make a sphere 1 mile in diameter to completely enclose the air inside. Warm that air by a few degrees Celsius and then sit back and let the whole sphere float up high. That's it. Did you notice that I didn't mention rockets or some big fans or sails, etc.? That's because the sphere would float just because of buoyancy. We can't directly sense it, but air is heavy. Right now, at this very moment, 10 tons of air is pushing down on you. That's like 10 cars right on top of you. We don't get crushed by that because we have the air inside of us and all that pressure equalizes. But what happens when it doesn't? This gasoline tank can demonstrate just how heavy the air is. The maximum buoyancy force from the air at the sea level at 20 degrees Celsius is 1.2 kilograms per cubic meter. This means that the air can lift the maximum of 1.2 kilograms per cubic meter. The average volume of a hot air balloon is around 3000 cubic meters. If we were to use this formula, we can calculate that if we were to heat up the air inside of the envelope by 100 degrees Celsius, the density difference that would occur would allow us to lift 760 kilograms with that balloon. But a mile wide sphere contains way more air than ordinary hot air balloons. 700,000 times more to be exact. 2.5 million tons of air. Since we have more air to work with, we don't have to drastically increase the temperature for us to have a liftoff. We can increase it by just a few degrees. If we were to use the same formula as before, we would see that this sphere could lift 24,000 tons if we were to increase the air temperature by just a 5 degrees. Does it take a lot of energy to heat up that much air, even by a few degrees? Yes, absolutely. It takes a lot of energy. This much energy, to be precise. In other words, we would need a 17 megawatt heater to work without stopping over the period of 10 days to heat up that much air by just a 5 degrees. But that's not that much compared to the energy from the sunlight that that sphere would receive. The top part of the mild white sphere would receive this much energy on a clear day at the equator. That's more than enough energy to heat up all that air. Whether or not this is a feasible idea is out of my knowledge, but nonetheless it's a nice little thought experiment. Imagine that, floating around the globe in a city ship. How about you? Do you have any crazy ideas like this one? Share them with us down below. Thanks for watching.